क्लास 12th सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स 16th चैप्टर सेमीकंडक्टर डिवाइसेस फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर लेट अस सी लाइट इमिटिंग डायोड इन शॉर्ट इट इज कॉल्ड एज LED सो लेट अस सी व्हाट इज दिस लाइट इमिटिंग डायोड द लाइट इमिटिंग डायोड इज ए पीएन जंक्शन डायोड which emits light when a large forward current passes through it. Light emitting diode is a PN junction diode which emits light when a large forward current passes through it. That is, it converts electric energy into light energy. The symbol and the schematic diagram of the LED are as shown. So let us see this symbolically. LED is shown as it is. It is a PN junction diode having two electrodes, anode and cathode. Then light will be emitted from this PN junction diode. Then if you consider the schematic diagram, then the schematic diagram of this LED is as shown here. This will be the epoxy lens. Then here there will be a wire bond. Then here it is reflecting cavity. Then these are the two electrodes which are connected in the external circuit, and these are namely anode that is positive and cathode that is negative. Now if we consider the construction of this LED, then that construction will be given as the N region of this LED is heavily doped. So if you consider the N region of this LED, it is always heavily doped as compared with the P region of the PN junction diode. So if you consider this block diagram, then here there is P type region, here it is N type region. Then in this case, this N region is now heavily doped as compared with this P region. Then the LED PN junction is enclosed in a dome shape. It will be enclosed like this in a dome shape, transparent case, so that light emitted is spread uniformly in all directions. So due to the dome shaped case, that transparent case, the light will be uniformly spread in all directions when it is emitted from the PN junction, and the internal reflection is minimized. So there will be minimum internal reflection of that light emitted from the PN junction. Then the metal electrodes, these are the metal electrodes here, which are attached on either side of the PN junction, will serve as the contacts for the external electrical connections. So these are the electrodes which are connected on either side. They will be serving as the contacts for external electrical connections, that is, it will be connected in the external circuit. And now let us see the working of this LED. So in this case, this is the P-type region, this is N-type region. In order to provide the forward bias to this PN junction, P region is connected to positive terminal, N region is connected to negative terminal of the external source. As soon as PN junction is formed, at that time it will give rise to this depletion region. So this will be the width of depletion region. Then P region will be consisting of holes, N region will be consisting of electrons. Then as soon as the large forward bias current is sent through this PN junction, at that time the electron hole pairs will be generated and there will be recombination of the electrons and holes at this region. And due to the recombination of electrons and holes, at that time the light will be emitted from this PN junction. So this will represent a free electron here. And so let us see the working of this LED. When the diode is forward bias, the electrons from the semiconductor's conduction band recombine with the holes from the valence band. When the diode is forward bias, the electrons from the semiconductor's conduction band recombine with the holes from the valence band, and it will release sufficient energy to produce the photons which emit monochromatic light. So due to the recombination of the holes and the electrons, the monochromatic light will be emitted in the form of photons. Then because of the thin layer, so this layer will be thin, so because of this thin layer, a reasonable number of these photons can leave the PN junction and emit colored light. So different colored light will be emitted due to the reasonable number of these photons. Then the amount of light output is directly proportional to the forward current. The light emitted here, this amount of light emitted or output light emitted will now depend upon the forward current, and it will be directly proportional to this forward current. That is, for small value of forward current, intensity of light will be small. If forward current is increased, then the amount of light output will increase. And thus, we can say that higher the forward current, higher the forward current, higher is the light output. Now, the LED are fabricated by using the compound semiconductors made with elements such as gallium, phosphorus, arsenic, etc. So for the fabrication of LED, the materials used are the compound semiconductors such as gallium, phosphorus, arsenic, etc. Now, by varying the proportions, of these elements in the fabrication of the LED, if the proportion of these compound semiconductors are varying, then in semiconducting materials, if there is variation, then it is possible to produce light of different wavelengths. So by changing the proportion of these semiconductor compounds, it is possible to produce the light of different wavelengths. For example, if you consider aluminium gallium arsenide, that compound semiconductor, that is aluminium gallium arsenide, then it will emit infrared radiations. Similarly, gallium arsenic phosphide will give rise to yellow light. Aluminium gallium phosphide will give rise to red light. So this will be regarding the working of lead. So in short, due to the recombination of the electrons and holes at this junction, the light will be emitted. Now, if you consider the IV characteristics of this LED, then the nature of the graph for this IV characteristics will be as shown. So here, current will be plotted along y-axis, voltage will be plotted along x-axis, and therefore in this case, as voltage increases, that is, as forward bias voltage increases, forward bias current will go on increasing. So in this way, nature of the graph will be there. So as forward bias current flowing through the junction increases, the light emitted will increase, and in this case, as voltage increases, here current will increase. So this will be the IV characteristics of LED. Now let us see some of the advantages of LED. It will be having some of the advantages. So what are the advantages of this LED? First one, they are energy efficient. LED are energy efficient. Second, they are having longer lifetime. They are having longer lifetime. Third, they are not having filament, tube or bulb to break. So in case of LED, there will be no any filament or any tube or any bulb so that it will break. Fourth will be, for LED, no warm-up period is required. That is, light will be emitted in few seconds only, and therefore there is no warm-up period required for LED. Fifth one is, they have excellent color rendering. Excellent color rendering will be there for these LED. Similarly, sixth one, they do not contain mercury or any harmful substance. So mercury or any other harmful substance is not contained in case of LED. Similarly, seventh one, the brightness and color of light emitted by LEDs can be controlled. The brightness and color of light emitted by the LEDs can be controlled. And now let us see some of the disadvantages of LED. So first one will be, they possess harmful blue light quality. They will possess harmful blue light quality. Second, they are temperature dependent. That is, there will be change in the properties of LED with temperature. Third, they have low voltage sensitivity. They have low voltage sensitivity. That is, for very very small change in voltage, there will be change in the properties of these LEDs. And fourth one is, their initial cost is high. Their initial cost is high. So these are some of the disadvantages of LED. And now let us see some of the applications of LED. So various applications of LED are there. And these applications are as follows. LEDs are used in burglar alarm system. LEDs are used in burglar alarm system. They are used in optical communication. They are used in optical communication. They are used in indicator lamps in electric equipments. They are used in electric equipments as the indicator lamps. They are used in display system of a cell phone handset. They are used in display system of a cell phone handset. Then they are used in television. They are used in television. Similarly, they are used in vehicle headlights. In case of vehicle headlights, they are also used in domestic and decorate illumination, for domestic illumination as well as for the decoration, these LEDs are used. Similarly, the LEDs are used in street lighting. In case of street lighting, these LEDs are used. So these are some of the applications of LED.